What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. And today we are at Islands of Adventure and Universal Studios. This is the 100 subscriber special. We are spending 3 days here. We've already spent 3 days before. However, it's just been a bad time to film because of the rain. But we are back better than ever doing a 100 subscriber special for you guys. I'm really excited to explore the two parks. Due to things that they have to offer, and we've got Ben here with us. It's gonna be a great time. Again, we have 3 days here, so we're gonna do everything we can, and we are gonna dive right into it.
Hundreds of years of Hogwarts history in a few short hours. Enjoy your stay.
Here's the boot. That's right. Keep your voices down. Everything's going to be fine.
Information I can be in part of me.
Ready? Yeah, man. I'll
take you
right
in the room. Yes, it was done.
A little bit ago, we did the Harry Potter Forbidden Journey and Hagrid's motorbike, and I'm just gonna say the motorbike was really good. I really liked the launches and the drop. That was just really exciting, and I think it is the most unique coaster at Islands of Adventure. We also did the Forbidden Journey, which I just think is one of the greatest rides ever. It was really immersive, and I'm just a big fan of Harry Potter, so that was something I really liked. But now, as you can see, I'm in a different outfit. We are going to knock out all of the water rides, we'll see how it goes. Well, we just did all the water rides that were open, and I'm damp as heck, so gonna change to a new outfit. And then we also did the cat run, which is way better than I was actually expecting. But now we are gonna go to VelociCoaster. So we just finished up in the superhero area of Islands, and we didn't get a whole lot of footage in that area, We did do the Dr. Doom ride. It's just your standard drop tower, but we actually launched up. That one was a pretty good drop tower, I would say. If there is a way, the great drop towers. And then there's also the Spider-Man ride in the area, which we didn't do today, but we did do it when we didn't have the camera rolling, and I would say Spider-Man is a great ride. It's definitely one of the best rides here. I would definitely recommend checking out Spider-Man. And then the Hulk coaster we didn't do today also, but I would say that the Hulk is one of the best coasters in the two parks in this area. I definitely recommend checking that out as well. But now we are in Toon Lagoon. So Kong is another ride that we're not going to do tonight, but is a ride that we did another night ago. I will tell you this, Kong is probably good if you've watched it. I have never watched it before. Honestly, in my opinion, the ride was good, but it was not worth the wait of an hour of continuing our watch of Jurassic Park. Well, we just did Velocicoaster at night.
Ben, your thoughts?
Unbelievable. Yeah. That basically sums it up. Yesterday we did it towards the front during the day. It wasn't as intense, I would say. Now at nighttime and in the back is very intense. It is a very different ride. Velocicoaster overall is the best coaster at the resort, period. It is also very good in terms of all the other stuff in the world. So that is something. We basically finished up at Jurassic Park, and now we are just basically
winding down our time here at Islands Adventure. And yeah.
This part of the Orlando Subscriber Special, we are done at Islands of Adventure, and now we are going to go do the Universal Studios side of the resort, and yeah. Part 2 of the 100 Subscriber Special in Islands of Adventure and Universal Studios. We just finished the Hippogriff ride, which is a great kiddie area. Now we're hopping on the train to go to Universal Studios. And I'm just going to say this. Hogsmeade is an incredible area. And it is just, it's very incredible. And I recommend checking it out if you guys go to Islands of Adventure. It is just incredible. It's basically exactly like the movie. We are gonna hop on the train now and go to Universal Studios.
happening? Hey, Wagwa Max.
But we just finished up at the Leek Cauldron in Diagon Alley. It was good food, by the way. And we also did the telephone booth. That was pretty interesting. But now we are going to go over to the Minion area and do the stuff there, including Rip Ride Rocket. We just did VillainCon and the Minion Mayhem ride. I'm going to tell you what I think the Minion, the VillainCon ride is pretty unique. And then I thought that the Mayhem ride was actually really cool. It was a lot like Minion Rush. Now we're going to go to the Jimmy Fallon ride and we'll see what happens there. Just finished up the Jimmy Fallon ride, and I'm telling you, that was probably one of my favorites personally. Really funny. It was actually pretty long too. It was just one of my favorite rides. Inside, now we are actually going to go do Hollywood Whip Ride Rocket. I don't know what to expect, but we'll see ya when it's done. Hollywood Rip Ride Rocket.
Dan, what'd you think of the ride?
I thought it was pretty good. I just think it was a little too, I think it was kind of shaky. So, you know, just, I thought it was all right. Decent.
I actually thought it was pretty good. A little shaky though, kind of like Ben said. With that being said, it's still a good coaster though. I don't know what you're thinking, but
yeah, had some pretty good ejector airtime. Had some good ejector airtime. And that non-rear element was cool. Besides that, that's it, I think.
Yeah, well, now we're heading over to the ET ride. I don't really know what to think of the ET ride yet. We've never done it in our lives, but we're gonna do it now, so we'll see what happens. We actually haven't done the ET ride yet, but we did make a stop at the Simpsons ride and the Men in Black ride. The Simpsons ride, I think, is actually one of the best in the park. Just really good. It's actually really nice, which I do recommend checking it out. And then the Men in Black, I gave it a lot of criticism at first, but I read it again. It's actually not as bad as I think people make it as. The Men in Black ride is actually not as bad as I originally thought. So now we are actually going to do the ET ride. We did the ET ride. Honestly, there's not really much I need to say about it. It's just kind of there at this point. It was probably good back in the day, but its time has passed.
Yeah, Mardi, the real Mardi Gras.
Alright, so we just saw the Mardi Gras parade. I'm covered in bracelets.
And so is Ben. Yeah. What do you think of the parade?
That was a pretty nice parade. You know, a lot going on, a lot of great music. Very colorful, you know? It's just how, you know, very enjoyable. So, yeah, I really liked it. That parade was pretty good, I would say. Universal celebrating Mardi Gras. I guess it's a thing every year. I'm not really sure. But we have about finished our night here at Universal Studios. We are mostly done here at Universal Studios, minus the Diagon Alley and the Simpsons area. Our night here has been great, and we still got one more day to go here at Universal. So here we go for the third day.
Back for the third day of our subscriber special. I said we were gonna do Diagon Alley and Simpsons Land, but before we do that, we got Chocolate Frog.
Gotta try it. If I can open it.
Yeah. Alright, finally got it open. Gonna try it right now.
I don't know where I should start it.
Really good. Yeah, these are great.
Alright, but seriously, we are back in Universal Studios. We gotta do Diagon Alley and the Simpsons Land, which we haven't really done yet. I don't know what we'll do after that, but we'll just have to wait and see.
So we just finished Gringotts. How did you think the ride was?
I think it was very good. Very fast at some points. Some quick turns. I actually really liked it. Ben, would you can you say the same?
Yeah, it's a really good dark ride. The theming's great. Storyline's great. Great ride in general.
Ben, we just did Revenge of the Mummy. You have anything to say about that?
That was a very good ride.
Yeah, very, very good ride.
It was dark, but I actually quite enjoyed it. It is worth the wait. We did some other stuff as well. We actually got lunch beforehand, but now we are finally gonna go and do Diagon Alley for real this time.
Wow.
we bought some wands and we tried to do some magic. Obviously, not very experienced doing magic, so it kind of failed. But we were able to get some spells casted, which was good, I guess. Now we have finished up at Diagon Alley, and now we are heading over to Simpsons Land. So we have just received the big pink. It's right here. Just got the big pink, and we're gonna give you guys a first-hand opinion on the donuts. So let's see what it tastes like. Let's see if I can actually get this thing. This thing is massive. That is a good donut. That's all that needs to be said. It's a lot. It's obviously very large. And it's got a lot of sprinkles on. There's your first-hand look and opinion on the donut. It's good. It's a good donut. Well, that is going to do it for the 100 subscriber special. And by the way, we did eat all of the donut. It was pretty big, and I will admit it was pretty filling. And that is going to do it for the 100 subscriber special. I definitely recommend checking out Universal and Islands of Adventure. They are just incredible theme parks. Some of the best in the world. And if you guys want to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe and leave a like. I will see you guys on the next video, and yeah.